Welcome everyone to today's project finance and infrastructure modeling session. I'm really glad you're here and it's nice to meet you. If you have any questions throughout, please feel free just to jump in and use the chat function in Zoom and I'll answer them as soon as I can. I've also got some time dedicated at the back end as well. So if you'd rather just wait and you feel better doing so, please also do that. I'll try to keep this as brief as I can, trying to keep it to 15 minutes so you can ask as many questions as you need to. Before diving into detail, I think it's worthwhile just introducing ourselves. If you're taking a financial modeling training course, you would love to probably know that the people actually leading the course have experience and they know what they're doing. So this is us on the screen. That's me on the bottom left, Haydn Palliser, and Dan Gross on the bottom right. And with Pivotal 180 courses, you're being taught by Dan or myself. We're not also people who have just studied this academically. We're also not people that only have a couple of years of experience. I've certainly got a few more gray hairs than that. And Dan, if you had here, has a few more gray hairs than me. We have invested in or advised on billions of dollars worth of transactions over a number of decades and all across the world. We'd like to say we've worked on all of the major continents except for Antarctica. And as I said, all the courses are led by either Dan or myself. Now, my introduction being a financial advisor in project finance for around 15 years. I've covered renewable energy, infrastructure, mining, oil and gas. I lived in New Zealand, Australia, Singapore, Abu Dhabi, Germany, UK, and the US. So, well, a lot of different countries. After working in Sydney, after my early days as an engineer, I worked for a company called Navigator Project Finance. I then led a company called Corality across Americas, Europe, Middle East, and Africa region before I became a partner in an accounting firm called Mazar. I was co-head there of the infrastructure and energy practice across the Americas. And for a period of time there, I was also the global head of financial modeling. So I've led financial modeling engagements and project finance engagements for valuations, for transactions, for strategy, for airlines. I've done a lot of different financial modeling. And as part of my job, I've trained over 1,000 analysts all around the world. I'm also a lecturer at Yale University and an adjunct professor at Columbia. Now, Dan is similar, but also a little bit different. So Dan's career started off at General Ledger, where he ultimately became the head of renewable energy investments. At the time, they were the largest investor in power assets in the US. After that, he moved across to Goldman Sachs, where he was in the special situations group, basically investing Goldman Sachs' own money into private equity. And he ultimately seeded a couple of really very well-known companies in the US, one which was SunEdison, upon which he was on the board of. He got off that well before the business went under. After that, he raised his own fund of around $1 billion in 2009. That was no easy feat at that time in the market. And during that time, that's when Dan really found his true passion in teaching. And he's been teaching since then, both at Columbia as an adjunct professor and as a lecturer at Yale. Now, we actually met each other at Columbia and we now co-teach there together. So we've had a lot of real world experience. We're not just sort of the academics. We're not people without the full broad experience, but we really have a true passion for teaching. And we've taken a lot of years to develop the material we've got and the thought process and the way of approaching things. And we truly care about how people assimilate information. So that's enough about us. And we can move on to the next piece. And the first question we get asked is, why take out courses? And I think the first one is if you want to distinguish yourself either from other people in your team or from other organizations. And doing our course, you can significantly improve your best practice modeling skills with a real emphasis on the concepts and focusing on what's important to the transaction, not just how to code every single line in a model, but what really matters. And best practice models are critical in project finance. This could be a chance to maybe impress your colleagues or business partners with some newfound clarity. And it also will give you a chance to consolidate your understanding of how all of the legal documents tie together with the model and how to structure and how to size an investment. It's not just modeling, it's how to do a transaction. Obviously, if you're looking to find a job in the sector, this course will certainly arm you with some of the tools that you would need in, say, job interviews. Most job interviews will include a financial modeling component, and financial modeling will be assuming you're an analyst or associate, will be a large part of your job. So the course will certainly help you ace your interview and your first few years on the job. But as I said earlier, it's not just about financial modeling. You need to be able to speak concretely about deal structures and documents required and what are the commercial realities of what you're actually modeling. It's also a good chance to take a step back and refresh yourself. Often you follow this one trajectory. You leave university, you do a bunch of things, but you never get a chance to step back and consolidate all of your thoughts into why are you doing what you're doing. So you may have been involved in project finance for 5 or 6 or 7 years, and often those people are the ones that love the course the most. They go, I wish I knew this 2 years or 3 years or 5 years ago. It's also maybe you're on one aspect of project finance. Maybe you're in originations on a debt desk. Maybe you're in the investing team on the equity side. You don't always have a chance to see how all these pieces come together. So it's also a great way just to get that broader understanding. Who attends our courses? Well, clearly we get a number of students. So they're looking to get a job, and this course gives you all the right skills if you're a student looking to get into a job and also help ace the interview, as I said. But really, we have the two biggest cohorts in these deals. First is what we call the first to fourth year, or maybe fifth year analysts and associates or financial modelers. These are the people that in their day jobs need to build financial models, review financial models, read loan documents. And so what they do in this course, or what you would do in this course if you're one of those, is apply these skills the very next day. It's not an academic course. We build a model from scratch. We discuss the documents. We talk how things tie together. So this really is about learning the skills you need for your job tomorrow. But we also get a lot of what I like to call mid-career changes. And perhaps you're MBA students. Perhaps you've been an engineer. You've been dealing with construction contracts the last 5 or 6 years. Or you've been working on a bond trading desk. And you'd like to transfer the skills you already have into the skills you need into the project finance world. You need to understand how to build these really complex financial models. They're more complicated than you might find in typical corporate finance or M&A roles. You also need to understand how the legal documents tie together. Those concepts themselves may be quite new to you, but you already have a pretty good understanding of finance. And so this is really another major part of our people that come in our courses. So these second and third bullet points here are the majority of people. However, there are also a lot of senior participants. So maybe you're in a business development role. You don't get quite so involved in all the details of a project finance transaction, but you'd like to understand it just that little bit more. It could be you've got less of a project finance background, but you're actually responsible for running a financial modeling team. Maybe you're a general manager and that financial modeling team reports to you. And ultimately you make decisions off that financial model. How do you ask the right questions of those people? You need to learn what are the questions I need to ask or to check the analysts or the financial modelers done their job. Or you just have to evaluate their work as a whole. Are they doing what I expect to? Do their models look anything like what I would learn on a Pivotal 180 course? If not, then it might give you cause for concern. So you don't do this work every day, but you have to review it. And again, it's your chance to step back and sort of look at the bigger picture as well. I think the other group here, though, maybe not necessarily senior participants, but I categorize in the same sort of way, is government employees. Maybe you don't build financial models every day to assess deals, but you're a government employee and you have to negotiate against the private sector. You might be in a public-private partnership team in a government organization. And you have to evaluate whether, say, an unsolicited offer to build a hospital or a toll road represents value for money for you as the government, and you'd also like to back calculate the economics of the private sector. Is this a reasonable deal? Are the returns reasonable for the type of thing they're doing? You would need to understand how the private sector thinks. And this course will help you think through exactly that, how an investor and a developer thinks. So what's covered in the course? Well, look, ultimately we're building a Wall Street caliber project finance model from scratch. Clearly we're doing that. But we firmly believe at Pivotal 180 that you cannot learn modeling if you do not understand the broader transaction. It's not just about modeling. The model is extremely critical, but you need to understand how it ties together with risks and documentation. So what are the risks? how they mitigate it, how do the contracts deal with risk, and what are the most critical elements for me to actually model. We are not just modeling coders, and we find that many of the other trainers in the project finance training world are just that. They don't cover things that we do, like the documents, risk, and build what we think are the world's best financial models. One thing to note here is this course, as I said, is designed to be as international as possible. So the financial model actually covers both what we call a pass-through structure in the US, where tax is not paid at the project company level, it's paid by the ultimate shareholders. But we also cover when tax is paid at the SPV or the project level, which is much more common through the rest of the world. So we look at both structures and we model them both. So it's suitable for people all across the world. We have a model familiarization video if you'd like to look and see what's in the model itself. But ultimately, we learn how to size debt, how to structure it, work out the repayments with DSCR sculpting. We model the covenants, such as the debt service coverage ratio, the DSCR, or the loan life coverage ratio, the LLCR. We calculate all the operational calculations, determine what are the project cash flows. We run scenarios and sensitivities. We're constantly doing that throughout the course. If we add something, how does that change the economics to all the different parties? Calculate tax and depreciation. We learn how to build three-way financial statements. Understand the different types of investors and equity and the types of returns they may expect. Debt service and maintenance reserve accounts, shareholder loans, outputs, given ultimately you make a decision off this model, we have to have well-presented outputs to tell a story. And finally, how to optimize a transaction with an introduction into VBA. How do we teach? Well, there's a couple of different options for you. Number one is online self-paced learning, and you have 12 months of access to this. And in that 12 months, you have unlimited access. Everything's available on day one. And at the end of 12 months, you would lose access unless you purchase the subscription on the back end, which is $100 a year. And we're always adding things to the course. If you've bought a renewable energy modeling course, you would have seen a lot of information. It's probably almost gone up by about 30% or 40% since we launched it. And there's over 20 hours of actual content on here, of video content. So it's likely going to take you at least 40 to 50 hours, maybe 60 hours to complete. Our live stream courses have replaced what used to be our in-person public courses pre-COVID, and it's certainly a premium learning product. And here you can just buy a place on a session open to other people from other organizations, which is a great chance for networking. And these were in-person classes, so now we run them via Zoom, but they run as 9 sessions, 2.5 hour sessions each time. And the idea behind that is an 8-hour Zoom session, no matter how exciting we can try and make the course, it's just too hard to learn. It's not the optimal learning environment. And what we also do is we record all of the online sessions. So you can just go back and review the concepts to catch up, or maybe you missed a class. So you can just jump back into that and watch the whole thing again. And if you've got the live stream class, you get free access to the online self-paced course. And what's really good about this platform is in between the sessions, so we typically run about 2 sessions per week, but in between the sessions, we actually give you homework. And of course, it's optional, but the homework is there. It's provided to you to either review topics that we covered in class, maybe dive deeper into something we don't have time to cover, which will be available on your online portal, or perhaps it's to complete an exercise to just practice what you've learned. We find that everyone learns at a different speed. So although we go as slow as we can to really reinforce learning concepts in class, if it was too fast for you, you've got time in between classes to catch up. So they got really good feedback for that reason. And obviously, given it's a live session, we will give you detailed feedback on your model and your homework. And you can ask sort of any questions you would like. So we may go off topic, off the usual sort of structure of the courses, because people are interested in certain things. And we often end up staying around a little bit after class to answer additional questions as well. It is run across different time zones. So what's kind of fun about this one is you could be sitting in Toronto, Canada, and running a course with someone in Johannesburg in South Africa, and someone in Geneva in Switzerland, and someone in Tokyo, Japan. So that's kind of fun about it too. Our tailored courses are sort of the most premium product, and because we've worked all over the world and we've worked in lots of different sectors, we can tailor courses sort of to any type of deal. So We have tailored courses in the past to specific technologies, say maybe a toll road in Ghana or a hydropower project in Vietnam. We have tailored courses based on specific term sheets provided by clients and going beyond that, even to specific local tax regimes. But also given our experience, we can go way broader than our sort of typical list of courses. So we can teach things such as corporate governance or asset management or valuations, whatever other topic that is important to you. And with both the live stream and the tailored classes, you will also get free full access to our online course. In addition to the course here, we're talking about project finance and infrastructure. We also have our renewable energy course and our tax equity course. We are in the process of working up some other courses as well outside of the project finance game, but we're working on those courses at the moment. So we can also tailor courses that are not even in project finance. So whatever you're interested in. Right now, before I go to questions, I'd like to also quickly demonstrate the online learning platform because I think it's worthwhile just seeing how that looks. But I'll stick to some questions. Actually, let me ask some of the questions that aren't some of the questions because there's a few here. Okay, the first question is, how is the model useful for any country? How tailored is the tax? The tax is tailored generically, if that makes sense. So we cover both the pass-through structure, so there's no tax at the project company level, it's paid through the ultimate investor, and we do tax at the project level. You know, we look at things like retained earnings traps on dividends, we look at, we discuss alternative minimum tax, but it is broadly generic for what I would say is the most sort of common structure that I've seen all around the world. So it's not specifically tailored to one country. It talks about a lot of different countries and uses different tax rates. If you're interested in something more tailored than that, to say a project in Japan, well, then we can certainly tailor things to anything you would like in a tailored session. Okay. How long are the live sessions? How frequently they occur and what days of the week? So the live sessions are 2.5 hours. Sometimes we might schedule something for 3 hours, and they're typically twice per week, depending on schedules, and sometimes they're up to 3 times a week. Which days of the week, it varies. Typically, we like to do Tuesday, Thursday on a two-session week. Is there a way to transition from the online course to the live stream course? Yes. If you buy an online course and you then decide, look, online just self-paced is not right for me. I want to have an instructor talk me through things, then you can buy the live stream course. It will give you full credit for the online course. Okay. On the online course, you have access to see what others are posting in the discussion session. Okay, so there's a discussion forum on the online platform, which I'll show you briefly. You can see everybody's questions on the discussion forum unless they hide it, which is actually pretty rare. Most of the time, people want to share their questions, but if you're not comfortable with that, you can make it private. Is there an overlap between the infra course and renewables? Yes. Ultimately, the way you structure and sculpt debt between renewables and most project finance deals is relatively similar. How you calculate a debt service reserve account is similar. How you build three-way statements is similar. How you calculate book depreciation and tax depreciation is similar with some differences in terms of, you know, the specific methods. But there's a lot of overlap from that sense. The big differences are in terms of operational calculations. Clearly, very, very different. A PPP, which is done as a hospital public-private partnership, this the main model, and they have a toll road model to download. That is very, very different to a renewable energy transaction. And you've got to consider things like the authority or the government themselves putting in money to the project. So there is some differences there. And actually the project finance and infrastructure model is slightly larger with a few more things in it than the renewables course, in that it has a maintenance reserve account in there. It's got tax and the three-way statements. There's an option to turn that on and off. So it's a little bit more international, the renewables course, which is a little bit more tailored towards the US market. Do you focus only on PPPs or P3s, public-private partnerships? At the moment, primarily, but we will be broadening this out. So, you know, the core project finance skills are the same. If you're looking at a mining transaction, if you're looking at oil and gas transaction, there's not that much difference from most of the items except for the operational calculations, a couple of different ratios, but largely they're similar. We'll be broadening this out in the infrastructure world shortly, but we will also be adding some additional subsectors of the course over time. Final question, is this course designed solely for people who already work in project finance? No, it's not. It starts from the absolute basics. We've got great feedback from people who have done this course with 10 years experience, and equally great feedback from people who are fresh out of college or in college. It really starts from the bottom up, and you can kind of pick and choose what you focus on. So with that, actually, I'm going to open up the online platform and just show you a quick demonstration of that. So here we are in the online platform, and I'm in the Project Finance Infrastructure course. On the left-hand side here, we can see a bunch of what we call chapters. The chapters are big groups of information like project finance, term loans. And within each of those chapters, we have lessons which are going into detail each of those different topics. So, for example, here is a video with a white screen and us talking through something which you can just play and stop. What you can do with this, which is great, you can speed it up. You can see I've got mine set to 1.5 times speed, mainly because I'm tired of listening to our own voices, but you can put it any speed you'd like and play and stop.
They wouldn't be so happy.
Needed.
Lenders seem like inherently nervous people. And
now what you also see in these videos is a full video transcription. So if you're not sure if you want to watch this video, you think, oh, I don't want to watch this 7-minute video, then quickly scroll through and see if there's anything new that I do not know in here. And maybe you come across something and say, what's this amortization thing? I want to understand what that thing is. You could copy that amortization text and you can come up here. If you select subtitles, I can either turn them on, and once they're on, I can click this top arrow, or I can just search video and I could either copy in or type in amortization. And when I click on amortization here, it's going to take me to that exact point of the video where amortization is discussed. So it's a really searchable group. Although this topic has no discussions, this is a relatively simple video, discussions are located in the top right here. So you can pose any questions you'd like to in here. And as you post a question, you'll see the responses from the instructor come up below. And again, as you create this, you can make this private if you'd like. Now, these lessons could be a video like I'm showing here, or it could be a quiz. It could be a download that you need. There's a bunch of different lessons all the way through that that you can watch. But we ultimately recommend that you go top to bottom on this to understand everything, because the course really does build on itself. And of course, we have available things like our slides. So if you'd like to look at the slides, you can simply click on the slide lessons and see those ones as well. So sort of back up all of our videos as something for you to review yourselves. So I don't think there's any further questions. So I think that covers us for today. So thank you so much for sticking with me today. And any questions, feel free to email. Thank you.